Hi, thanks for joining us. Today we're on a quick adventure. We're at the dikes near Pitt River, and behind me is the remains of what was once the world's longest floating bridge. Let's go and explore.
In 1963, the Washington State Department of Transportation achieved a Guinness World Record when it constructed the world's longest floating bridge, which connected the cities of Bellevue and Seattle. The SR-520 bridge, completed in August 1963, measured 2.4 miles in length, with a floating section stretching for almost a mile and a half. The bridge carried four lanes of traffic, separated by a curb, that was later replaced with a simple Jersey barrier. At the center was a drawspan, which opened for large vessels to pass through when traversing the lake. The bridge served the Washington state for over 50 years, but its age began to show. The original Evergreen Point Floating Bridge was designed before the implementation of modern earthquake engineering standards, with vulnerabilities in its hollow support structures that could have failed in a major quake. Additionally, vibrations caused by storm surges and strong winds could have compromised the aging draw span, anchor cables, and pontoons, leading to structural failures in a major storm. This required the bridge to close to traffic during sustained wind gusts of 50 miles an hour, or that lasted more than 15 minutes. Although the original bridge carried two lanes of traffic in each direction, it didn't have shoulders or pedestrian and bicycle infrastructure. The lack of a shoulder led to congestion in the event of an accident, which blocked emergency services from accessing the bridge. The new bridge was dedicated on April 2, 2016, and was certified by Guinness World Records as the new world's longest floating bridge at a length of 7,708 feet long, a whole 130 feet longer than the bridge it replaced. The old bridge was deconstructed into sections of about 110 meters long. The original plan for the remains was to float them to an industrial site in Kenmore for disposal and recycling. However, the city rejected the plan, citing the possible release of toxins from the pontoon's concrete. The remains of the 50-year-old SR-520 bridge were hauled from Seattle to Pitt Meadows, British Columbia in 2016. The sections were eventually acquired by the True North Operations Group with the goal of repurposing them as pontoons for temporary or permanent docks, or offloading facilities, piers, or even offshore storage. But 4 years later, the majority of the pontoons continue to sit unused in the Pitt River. In Google Maps, you can see that there are 17 sections of the bridge moored along the edge of the Pitt River. Each one of those sections is 111 meters or almost 364 feet long.
On the other side of the Pitt River Bridge, closer to the mouth of the Pitt River, are an additional four sections of the SR-520 bridge, meaning that in total there's almost 2 kilometers of unused bridge sitting, waiting for a purpose. Hopefully they can find a use for these so that they're not sitting in the river indefinitely. Remember to hit subscribe so you can stay up to date on all our latest adventures. Until next time, it's time to exit through the gift shop.